Good morning, St. Rose. I'm Mr. Falgaris.
And I'm Malik, and this is St. Rose Live, your daily dose of everything happening here at St. Rose High School.
On this morning's edition, we have your morning prayer, the Pledge of Allegiance, the daily announcements, and our clip of the day. It's on a short edition for today. It's an early dismissal day, Wednesday, December 13th, 2017. It's early dismissal.
It's now time for this morning's prayer. Leading this morning's prayer is Sister Kathy Nance. Please wait for Sister Kathy to invite you to stand. Put yourselves in the presence of God, clear your mind, open your heart, and please stand for this morning's prayer.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I invite you to take a moment to clear your desks, your minds, and your hearts of all clutter, and to place yourself in the presence of God. When there is a change in the pace of change, it's easy to get overwhelmed by it all. We live in a world where distance, time, and velocity are linear. But change is occurring exponentially. The only time we experience exponential growth in our daily lives is when a car is accelerating rapidly or decelerates very suddenly and comes to an abrupt halt. While it can be exhilarating, you wouldn't want to take a long trip like that. But that's exactly the trip we are on. We live in a perpetual state of acceleration. Advent invites us to pause. If you press pause on a machine, the machine stops. Press the pause button on a person, though, and they start. You start to reflect, you start to rethink your assumptions, you start to reimagine what is possible. You start to reconnect with your most deeply held beliefs. And once you have done that, then you can begin to imagine a better path. It's important to understand that we can choose to still our hearts. It may not be easy. But if we desire the authentic, heart-transforming experience of Christ's presence in the midst of the Christmas crazy, we can choose a holy pause. A holy pause is the opportunity to step out of the craziness, the demands, and the haste of the season, and to step into God's presence. It's the decision to shut ourselves away from the endless noise and commotion and quietly engage our hearts with His. It's the chance to trade our rushing for His stillness, our panic for His peace, and our irritability for His joy. Life doesn't stand still, but we can. Just for today, let us look for an opportunity to give ourselves the gift of a pause and to ponder for a moment what the gift of the Incarnation means to us. And so I invite you now to stand and pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus, you who took time to notice lilies bobbing, birds soaring, and bread rising, come and slow me down. You who took time to dine with acquaintances, go fishing with your apostles, and barbecue breakfast on the beach for your friends, come and slow me down. You who took time to play with children, listen to people's stories, and share their joys and sorrows, come and slow me down. When my mind is crammed with plans, when my to-do list is pages long, when I feel carried away by conflicting concerns, come and slow me down. Give me the grace to stop and to be with you, with others, with my own hopes, fears, questions, and dreams. Help me to bear you slowly but surely into the world, a world languishing and lovely, dark and delightful, sinful and saintly. I ask these things of you through Mary, the pondering disciple, your mother and mine. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Morning St. Rose. Today is Wednesday, December 13th, 2017. Today's schedule is early dismissal, and it starts the 12 days of Christmas. So there's actually 12 days until Christmas.
Nice.
All right, let's take a look at today's daily announcements. What do we got?
Where will you be on January 19th, 2018? Will you join the march with millions of other Americans and stand for the sanctity of human life?
The spots on the bus are filling up, and if you want to go on the trip, you need to pick up a permission slip in the main office. Have your parents sign it, return it to the main office, and bring your $10. That's going to secure your spot on the bus, and you'll be able to be there for the March for Life trip, January 19th.
Doctor's orders are in, and we have a prescription to fill. Operation Santa has begun. St. Rose is collecting medical supplies to benefit the Henry B. King Medical Brigade.
Do you remember the Henry B. King, the family, is the one who donated for the library here. So if it wasn't for that family, we wouldn't have the beautiful media center that we do have here at St. Rose. So they've supported us. It's now our turn to support them. And our support allows the medical brigade to work with over 2,500 people in their one-week visit. We're going to be showing you a little video later in today's show. So let's make the Santa Operation Santa happen this year.
Each class has been assigned a few key items to bring to the collection. Freshmen are to bring cough drops, sophomores, toothbrushes and toothpaste, juniors, Tylenol and children's Tylenol, and seniors, vitamins, no gummies.
And did you know that we are having a competition of what class can bring in the most, and that the vitamins count for double because vitamins are more expensive than a toothbrush. So yeah. Just know that, seniors, that your vitamins count twice to one toothbrush. Now, donations are being collected in the 100s card are. The bins are out there. The due date is December 19th, which is next week. We thank you for your generosity.
The guidance hallway will be closed to student traffic during lunch periods tomorrow. Please plan ahead and use an alternate route. The nurse's office will be open.
That's right. And those are your daily announcements. If you missed any of the announcements, check the monitors in the hallway or rewatch our show on our website.
It's now time for today's clip, daily trivia 10 questions. See if you and your classmates can answer today's trivia question.
10-second trivia. Which of these U.S. zoos is located the farthest south? Albuquerque Biopark Zoo, Chattanooga Zoo, North Carolina Zoo, or Santa Barbara Zoo? At just over 34 degrees north latitude, it's the Santa Barbara Zoo in Southern California that's the farthest south on this list.
As you know, Operation Santa is in full swing, and while there's a competition going to see which class can bring in the most items, the real winners are the members of the King Medical Brigade who bring in the supplies to the citizens of Honduras.
Here's a video introducing some of the people who are part of the brigade who will be bringing much-needed supplies along with their caring, love, and expertise to the people of Honduras, people who are in desperate need of medical care. Take a look.
Located in the mountains of Central America, Honduras is a mountainous country of 5.5 million people. It is widely regarded as the poorest country in Central America. 50% of the population is under 15 years old. 40% are either unemployed or underemployed. 10% of the population holds full-time jobs, with unskilled labor paying $2 a day. 70% of the people live in poverty. 75% suffer from malnutrition. There is little access to clean water. 12,000 children each year, or 36 each day, die a preventable disease.
And every time I've held a rose, it seems I only felt the thorns. And so it goes, and so it goes, and so will you soon, I suppose.
Every year since 1990, the Henry B. King Memorial Brigade has visited Honduras in order to deliver medical and dental care in a free clinic setting to the poorest of the poor. The medical brigade delivers care to about 3,000 or more patients as members travel from village to village with medical supplies and equipment donated in the United States. The team consists of doctors, dentists, physical therapists, registered nurses, EMTs, translators, and aides. Once in Honduras, members establish a base of operations in Santa Barbara province and travel daily to remote villages in the mountains and sugarcane fields. Medical and dental care is so scarce in this part of Honduras that some people have never been seen by a doctor. In order to continue to bring medical care and to extend our outreach to other areas of Honduras, we need your help. An effort of this magnitude requires substantial funding, beyond the means of the brigade, so we ask that you please help in any way you can. Items such as toothbrushes, vitamins, Tums, skin creams including antibiotic, diaper rash, anti-itch, and antifungal, Tylenol, lice-killing shampoo, cough and cold medicines, shampoos, conditioners, and monetary donations are needed. Together, we can all make a difference.
And so it goes, and so it goes, and you're the only one who
knows. It's now time for today's clip of the day. It's so cold today. Have you noticed? When cold weather doesn't bother giant pandas, they're native to Western China, and experts say they're actually more active in the cold. But who would expect them to want to play in the cold?
Mei Zhang, a giant panda at the National Zoo in Washington, D.C., showed us how enthusiastic she is about the snow by rolling in it. Her body language is pretty much says it all. And that's today's clip of the day.
Look at that panda. You can never beat a cute panda video.
Yeah.
That's it. Well, remember, it's early dismissal today, so check your schedule. It's on Schoology for the early dismissal schedule for the day with the bells. Thanks for watching this edition of St. Rose Live. We hope you enjoyed it. I'm Mr. Falgaris.
And I'm Alec. Have a great day here at St. Rose. See you tomorrow. Thank you, and God bless.